of the state basketball tournament as it is, COVID 2021. And I'm so excited to have Nev Red here with us. I'm going to ask her to introduce herself. She is a senior, one of the leaders on the Page Sand Devil team. And we're going to talk something about, other than basketball, imagine that, we're going to actually talk about some academics. But hey, Nev, introduce yourself.
I was born in Tuba City, but I've been living in Page since third grade, and I used to live in Phoenix. I am a senior at Page High School. I am attending Stanford University next year, majoring in biology, and my parents are Florinda Tracy and Joshua Redhair.
Man, oh man, I'll tell you what. You said Stanford University?
Yeah.
Stanford. I don't even know. I have to buy a vowel to spell that word. But you know what, Nev, we're going to talk about that in just a second. But I'd like to retrace your steps. You said you got here in third grade. And what's your field of choice when you go to Stanford?
Like my major?
Yeah.
Biology, because that's what my... My mom, she went to St. Louis and GCU, played basketball there, but that's what she majored in. So I'm just kind of like following her.
Follow her footsteps.
Yeah, because she's a PA right now. She works at the clinic in Lachey, and I've just admired her work, like kind of hearing secondhand of what she deals with, her patients, not her patient info, but her happy experiences being a PA. So I really like that field of work, and I've kind of grown up hearing it from her. So that's what kind of motivated me to try medicine, because it seems like a great field of medicine.
So ultimately biology, but that's a stepping stone to potentially medicine.
Yeah.
Did I hear somewhere you said that you might want to be a surgeon?
Yeah. Seriously? That's like my biggest goal. So how I look at it is throughout high school, I was kind of underestimating myself. I was like, maybe I'll go to U of A or ASU, you know, a state school.
You mean them crummy schools?
not necessarily.
Did you say that? I mean, come on.
But that's what I kind of thought in my head. So right. I was like, okay, I'm never going to Stanford or another school like Harvard. You know, all the Ivies and big top schools.
Sure.
But now that I kind of accomplished that goal, I'm kind of like, oh, what else can I do? So
right.
I think I'd want to become a surgeon. I don't necessarily know what type, because it could change throughout. But yeah, medical school is on my list. And
well, I heard a couple really good things in there, because in order to get, well, you know what, you had to study Stanford in order to even apply, right?
Mm-hmm.
And you said you had some exposure to Stanford because of some basketball.
Yeah.
Tell just a second about that. How did you get exposed to Stanford?
So my club team that I've been playing with, I think since we were about 10, it's been a lot of years, but the same starters that I start with right now, they were part of the team I grew up playing with.
You guys have been playing since you've been 10 years old, most of you?
About, yeah. I believe all five of us that are starting right now.
That's amazing, isn't it?
I grew up with them. So.
Wow.
Mm-hmm. We actually fundraised. We did like car washes and different sales. I can't remember exactly which, but we fundraised to go to a Stanford women's basketball camp, twice in a year. So we like took a van out there and we all traveled together. We spent, I believe it was like 3 days out there in a dorm, and we had a lot of fun. But, one of the things I remember there is they enforced, it was like hashtag Nerd Nation, something like that. And
right.
It was kind of the first time I realized you can be an athlete while also...
And still be a nerd.
Studying at a very prestigious college. So it kind of opened up doors for me in the terms of my own mind, thinking like, oh, I can still be really good at basketball, play through high school, but focus on academics as well.
Sure.
Because that's what the girls who were on the women's Stanford basketball team did, and I was like, if they can do it, I can. So I just took that home and applied, because
that's awesome.
So
again, third grade from here on this way, how did you just sustain kind of that desire? Because in order to sustain that desire, that takes a lot of work. It's just like basketball. Every day you practice the same things. And because it takes not only muscle memory, but it takes this, to think about what you're doing to the point where you don't have to think about it because it becomes natural. So about when did "I'm going to go to Stanford" become natural to you? What grade level? How did that? Because your mom planted the seeds, and probably continued to do that as you grew up. And she was the one, "You better get your homework done, you know, before you go out and feed the sheep and everything else," right?
Yeah. I think it started becoming like more realistic as I went up in high school throughout my different teachers. So right. My first teacher that I really loved, her name's Miss Vale. She was my
awesome teacher.
Yeah, she was my Algebra 2 teacher.
Yeah.
And she was just kind of like, wow, you're... Because I was a freshman in that class with like other juniors and seniors too. Because I started math a little early. But anyways, she was kind of like, oh, you're an amazing student. You know, just like encouraging me. And then my sophomore year, Mr. Dubay.
Oh, yeah.
He's my other pre-calc teacher. He was just like... I've known students who went to Vanderbilt, who went to Dartmouth, you know, other very nice schools. And he was like, "I think you're going to go somewhere like amazing." So wow. That really boosted my, boosted me up. So, yeah. And then Mr. Adams, he's my science teacher.
Josh?
Yeah. He taught me
chemistry. He was a good teacher?
Yeah.
Oh, come on.
He taught me chemistry.
Josh Adams?
He taught me chemistry, so that was fun because he made chemistry fun. I always hear like horror stories about, oh, chem, I hated that class, you know. But
really? That was my favorite class.
Well, berries.
Holy smokes. I love the ring.
Yeah, but he also encouraged me as well. Sure. And just kind of... other teachers as well, not just those three, but those are the main.
Three that kind of stood out.
Yeah.
But I'm sure every teacher you had said, you know what, let's keep going. You can do better and all those kind of things, right?
Yeah.
And they start feeding you more.
Mm-hmm. And then the main, Charlotte Nakadene, Miss
she coaches
us. Yeah, she's the counselor at the high school too.
Right.
So she wrote my teacher letter of recommendations and helped me. Because obviously in basketball and academics as well, she kind of helped me pave my way to go to like summer camps. I went to a research internship at Vanderbilt in Nashville.
What?
She helped me kind of
build all the way from the reservation to Vanderbilt.
Yeah.
My gosh.
So she helped me get a recommendation there and just kind of guided me along the way. So I think that group of teachers helped kind of shape.
Man, I tell you what, I'm hearing an earful, and I have to stay off of it. That's like a full 5-piece meal that you've just thrown out. But I mean, the key ingredients, first something was planted in you. Next, you had teachers that started pouring into you. Then you had a counselor that grabbed a hold of you. But that all went, you know, it all went side by side with the young ladies you grew up with too.
Yeah.
And just the group of people you grew up with.
Mm-hmm.
And I love the story of the support that, man, it just expanded your horizons like crazy. But then why did you finally settle on... Well, you probably applied to several schools, right? Or do you just pick Stanford out?
So I applied to Stanford for restrictive early action, which is like I applied, I think it was on October, and I know December.
Right.
So since I knew December, I also already applied to UCLA, UC Berkeley, UC Santa Barbara, those three because they were due in November. But once I got the email from Stanford, like, "You're accepted," I was like, "I don't want to apply anywhere else." Yeah,
done.
And I don't want to deal with that because it's just extra stress. Well, I'm applying for scholarships and already doing so many things.
Now, really, tell me the truth. Medical, yeah, but you know, all the schools you just said you applied to, you really want to just be on the beach and suntanning all day long. Yeah. I understand how that goes. But I can't help myself, and I don't know that I need to look at this. Do you know Stanford is the number 5 top medical school in the country?
I think I looked at that.
Okay.
Yeah, I might have Googled it.
I Googled it too, but they won't accept me. but the number 5 in the country, and I started looking at what Stanford allowed to be, you know, because they have a lot of students that apply for certain schools. And in your area, 45,000 students, and this is in 2023 range. They're already looking at 2023. 45,000 students, and they accepted 2,000. It was way back, I think the last time they had double digit acceptance, that means 10% or more of the class that applied got in.
Yeah.
2011 was the last time they had double digits. Oh, Stanford is the hardest university to get into in the United States. They've got a 4.3% acceptance rate. You're the 4.3.
Yeah, and I was crazy. Like, that statistic just ran through my head when I looked at that email. I was like,
yeah, seriously? How am I? There's no way I can, you know, I'm from the Chi. But isn't that a tremendous thing?
Yeah.
You know, and I do want to say that we're going to talk to Jonah Holiday because he got accepted to ASU Barrett's honor school, and that's really quite an accomplishment as well. Already an accomplishment, but it's the beginning of a, you know, you've climbed a kind of a steep hill in academics, but also in basketball and those kind of things. Mm-hmm. But once you say, you know what, this isn't that bad, we can get this done. Hey, Nev, you've really run quite a race here in Page, Arizona, LaCheek, and coming to Page, Page Unified School District. And there's a lot of kids out there that look up to you guys. So parting words as your senior year is coming to an end, believe it or not, to them, and how would you, just real simple advice would you give them?
I would say to just simply step out of your comfort zone. That's what I did. Not so much my freshman and sophomore year, but as I've grown up and I just did what I wanted to do, and like I thought, join student council, join clubs, do sports you think you might like. Just step out of your comfort zone, and I think it'll really benefit you in the long run. That's what I've got to say.
You know, great advice, and what you say really is a tag to one thing that really is a given. One, that participate in something else. And like you said, open your horizons up a little bit. Mm-hmm. Be able to dream dreams, right? And so extracurricular things in the schools, get into music, get into drama, get into to science club, get into various things where you can start getting a flavor for what might be out there. And don't limit yourself in terms of possibility. Because when you had your eyes open at Stanford, how old were you?
Probably 12.
12 years old.
Yeah.
And now you're 42, finally graduating from high school, and you get into that school that is almost impossible to get into, right?
Yeah.
So don't be afraid to dream, go after it. But also, the intimidating thing about some of these schools, because the consistency of what you've done through high school really pays off, because they show the average ACT score of those that get into Stanford, the average SAT score that get in. Their scores, and it does say like 65% of their incoming class will be from public schools, which is really pretty interesting. And but anyway, you have to do the stuff. If you mess up a year, hey, just pick it up, right?
Yeah.
And so it's how you finish and finish strong, and because school is really, really important. And if you want to be a surgeon, you see these things right here? What are those?
Scars.
Because I've seen surgeons, and they every time I go see a surgeon, I know what I'm going to get. We got to replace your body parts. And so I got brand new knees, brand new hips from people that go to school like you, and they did a great job. And maybe if I'll still be around to hit you up and have another wing named after the Candyman, because I paid a lot of money to those people.
Sounds good.
Anyway, we're going to finish this, Nev. I want to talk to you about 2 minutes about the basketball stuff, but any final words to people? And I really appreciate you shouting out to those teachers, because that they really get people over the top. They get their students over the top, and giving those expectations that, hey, they can be yours.
Yeah, along with the support system I mentioned earlier, I just want to give a recognition to my coach, Ryan Whitehorse. He also he teaches the home health aid curriculum at the high school, and that's also got me into the CNA program that I'm taking at the community college here. But he was a big asset, along with Miss Nakadene, as far as binding together academics and athletics, and also the Booster Club this year for kind of helping.
Yay, boosters.
Yeah, because they paid for our meals when we went away. Ooh. So just kind of all the help they've done for us
and
this year to
snacks.
Make our season.
And all the snacks. Yeah, yeah, absolutely. Well, that's awesome. Mm-hmm. A couple minutes about tonight. Wickenburg, do you even know who they are? I mean, the Cowboys. No, Wickenburg.
I've watched like three
they're the
minutes
Wranglers.
Of film
they're the Wranglers.
On them.
Okay, so your assignment tonight?
Number 14.
That's Peterson.
Yeah, I believe so.
Okay, and why number 14?
I believe she's their second post, and most of the time Ryan will give me or Emma the assignments that
right,
we need
right.
to focus on, besides from the main post, but. I heard you say earlier they're their top two scorers, I believe.
Yeah, they are.
So, I'd probably want to, you know, shut them down.
Sure.
Hopefully win.
And hopefully win. Yeah, it's always up in the balance. That's why they play the game, so they say. We're here with Nev Redhair. Hey, she's a rock star. She is a pit bull when it comes down to defense. And I feel really sorry for Miss Claire Peterson. She's in trouble tonight. Hey, good luck tonight in the ballgame.
Thank you.
All right. Mm-hmm. Game, they were down by one at half and by four after the third, and they had to rally to win that one. So that's always a test. That's the one question I have about Paige. When, if they get put under pressure, how are they going to act? They played Winslow early, and that was a bit of a challenge. Mm-hmm. They won by 12 or 13. And so they haven't been really tested since that time. And so it's going to be interesting to see if we go up early, that's going to really bode well for the Sand Devils. If they put some pressure on us, I know the Lady Sandals are used to pressure, but you got to see it on the floor during the season, and we really haven't seen it. So it's going to be interesting.
No, but a lot of these girls were there last year in the playoffs.
Yuma Catholic has had great records with over 20 wins a season for the last 5 years. I just looked that much
Holy
up. The
God.
Last 2 years, though, they were bounced from the tournament by two of our friends, Ganado, the Hornets, bounced them. And then the prior year to that, Window Rock bounced them out of the tournament. So any of the teams they played from up here, they got bounced. And I said Wickenburg scores. Well, we talked about that. But their individual scoring, Kylie Mersham, number 12. She's a senior. She averages 17 points a ball game. Number 30, Rory Martinez. She's a senior. 11 points a ball game, and number four resellers, 10 points a ball game. Rory Martinez, the other Martinez, she's wearing number 10. Number 10, averages 10 rebounds a game. Rianne Martinez, 6 rebounds a game. Assists, the Sellers kid, 5 rebounds, 5 assists. Steals, Merchant 8, and they take about 6 threes a ball game, so they're not going to put the 3 up very much. They're going to try to get down low. They have bigs, 6'2", 6'6", 6'1", 6'. So they've got some big kids in here. And so it's going to be interesting to see how the Lady Sand Devils handle the size of the Yuma Catholic Shamrocks. But we're getting to be about close to game time, Mike. And coming up will be the national anthem, introduction of the teams. But like I said, the big thing for Paige, they're going to see if they can handle the size of the Shamrocks, because they do have size.
They have size, they have talent, and somebody said that they're not very disciplined.
Well, that was a take after watching some film.
Okay.
But hey, all you folks from Yuma Catholic, we're going to try to represent you well. But we have to do this broadcast as a radio broadcast, so if you're watching it, that's kind of the deal. We will call play-by-play in color, just like we're on radio, because we have a big radio audience. If we make a mistake and we call your kids the wrong names, hey, send all your notes to Mike Riley, O'Reilly, right, for this game.
Today.
Mike O'Reilly, and send me all the compliments.
As we prepare for a game like this, I'm not kidding. It's on my mind that I'm the product of a Catholic school, small Catholic school.
Well, sure,
school.
Absolutely. I was raised there.
Mm-hmm.
So,
not mine. I didn't see you in school in Cleveland.
I didn't even know there was a Cleveland. We got 1 minute, and Miss Alicia
Covington,
is coming
middle
in to
school
sing the
principal.
National anthem. All right.
That's cool. And so let's keep it right here. We're going to hear a buzzer in 45 seconds, and then I think we'll be getting ready for the national anthem. This is excitement.
Yeah.
We'll get the starting line when they do the.
Ladies and gentlemen.
Yeah, I've got their starting line.
Cool. I think we have to stand.
Sung tonight by Elisa Covington, the principal of Page Middle School.
Wow. Well done.
That was special.
Holy smokes.
Elisa Covington, the principal at the middle school here.
Yeah, her second job is being the principal. Her first job is singing the national anthem. That was just
excellent.
Absolutely awesome. Hey, well, now we got to get down to some business here.
Now I'm getting nervous.
Well.
I mean this is it. This is the game.
Well, I think it is.
Part two.
And so we're going to have the introduction of the starting lineups for both teams. And this Yuma Catholic Shamrocks will be introduced first.
Number four, Reese Sellers.
Bobby McGillard's team, Galliard's team, the Shamrocks being introduced. Number four, a sophomore, Reese Sellers. Introducing number 10, a sophomore, Ryan Martinez. Wearing number 12, Kylie Merchum. She is a senior.
Rory Martinez.
Number 30, Rory Martinez, the senior.
And number 44, Izzy Torok.
And number 44 will be Isabel or Izzy Torok, a senior.
Izzy.
Those are the Shamrocks.
And now, your starting lineup for the Page Sand Devils. Number 3.
Introducing the Page Sand Devils. A senior wearing number 3, Emma Yazzie.
Number 4, Nadia.
A senior wearing number 4, Nadia Begay.
Number 10, Neb.
Another senior wearing number 10, Neb Redhair.
Number 20, Makeda Tolliman.
Introducing a junior, number 20, Makeda Tolliman. And on the inside, the senior, number 50, Torrance Begay. And I got to introduce two girls that we didn't have the numbers of. It's number 42, Summer Begay, and number 52, Trinity Curley. I had to say that because I was calling them number 52 and number 42. So my apologies to those girls. They had come up from the JV, I believe.
Mm-hmm.
And so we're just going to get them a little prop up front.
Absolutely.
How's that? All right.
I hope we see them again.
Well, I'm excited. Today. We got this ball game getting ready to tip off here in Sand Devil Gymnasium. And I think they've got a crowd probably about, I think we're allowed 400 or 450 in this round, something like that. And we've got that.
And people behind us, too.
Yeah.
No, I mean, those, all those
oh, yeah,
folks
yeah,
up
absolutely.
There.
Absolutely. And here we go. We're getting ready for tip-off. As we said, the Shamrocks are tall and athletic. And Torrance McGale have her hands full. So will Nev Redair. She gets the assignment of some of the bigs. But the Lady Sand Devils, what they're going to depend on is their aggression and their defense. So we'll see how that turns out. They allow only 20 points a ball game over the season. Torrance McGay will be jumping. It's Ryan Martinez, a sophomore. And the ball goes up. Martinez controls the tip, and it's going to be out of bounds off the hands of her sister, Rory. So it'll belong to the Sand Devils. And the Sand Devils are going to face, looks like, man pressure right off the bat. And I'll tell you, these Yuma Catholic Shamrocks are going to try to get in their face. And there's a kicked ball. Merchum kicks it out of bounds. Inbounding will be Emma Yazzie. Makeda Tolliman. Out top it goes to Nadia Begay. And now the Shamrocks are going to sit back in the defense. Let's see what they do with this. They're going to sit back around the paint. Nadia Begay right side, out top. It goes to Emma Yazzie to Nev Redhair. Sand Devils have got to figure out what defense it is, and it's a man, so they'll start working on that. Tolliman to Nev Redhair. Puts it on the floor, gets it to Emma Yazzie. Nadia Begay, left wing. Out top it goes to Nev. She stops, puts up one just outside the elbow. Nev Redhair with the first basket of the ball game.
And she threw that up in a crowd.
Yeah, good take. Full court pressure by the Sand Devils. We're going to get to travel right off the bat as the Shamrocks a little bit saw that trap on the right side and just couldn't handle the pressure. Three-pointer on the way. Nadia Begay, no good. Rebound, Torrance Begay. Offensive board, and here go the Sand Devils back to work. Nev Redhair to Nadia Begay out top to Makeda Tolliman. Emma Yazzie thinks three, dives, drives baseline, backs it out to Torrance Begay. She's going to go up and in. Good! Off the backboard. A great job by Torrance Begay. Down court quickly, there's Ryan Martinez, a pass across the paint, and it's knocked off the hands of Tora. Turnover. Shamrocks.
That was headed for Izzy, but she had no chance of catching that.
Full court pressure by the Shamrocks to see what the Sand Devils can bring here. And a pass thrown awry, no good. Ryan Martinez hasn't, misses the basket. Nev Redhair with the rebound. And the Sand Devils on the attack inside, wide open. A pass by Torrance Begay. Bad, that was a beauty. And a left-hand finish by Emma Yazzie.
Yeah, there was a steal earlier, and Sand Devils might have given up a basket, but good defense came to the rescue.
And one, Emma Yazzie will go to the floor, go to the free throw line. So Sand Devils out 6-0, and the foul called on Ryan Martinez, her first.
A couple of officials discussing what was going on in that previous play.
Yeah, they're... I think they've got it straight. We'll see.
We'll see.
Okay, they're talking about a kicked ball involved here and talking about the potential for the sand. Let's see what they're going to decide. I'd heard something about a kicked ball, and it's a long discussion early on.
I thought that was a few minutes ago.
I'm going to have to warm up all over again. Emma Yazzie will shoot the free throw. Emma Yazzie is a 64% foul shooter, 16 for 25 on the season. Shot up, and it's good.
7-0, Sand Devils on top.
Shamrocks inbounding against this full court pressure. With the ball is Sellers. Sellers is double teamed, and now we're going to get a held ball.
Yeah.
I believe it's going to belong to the Shamrocks.
That's fine. That was good defense.
Those are called Sand Devil sandwiches. If you're not used to them, you better get used to them here. Sellers with it coming across the timeline, picked up by Nadia Begay. Sellers gets a screen from one of the Martinez. Takeaway. Emma Yazzie going down the left side. She loses the ball. She gets it out quickly. Another turnover in the corner. Yazzie, open three, and it's good. Yazzie bangs the three down, and we get a timeout by Coach Bobby McGalliard. 10-0 up on the Powwow Trading Post scoreboard. Let's take 30.
The Boilermakers Western States Apprenticeship Program is for you. A great career established to promote efficient and high-quality field construction by skilled craftsmen and craftswomen in the Boilermaker welding trade. You could participate in self-studies, paid on-the-job training, and in-classroom instruction. It's an earn-as-you-learn apprentice program. Request your application for apprenticeship at www.westernstatesjac.org. The Boilermakers Western States Apprentice Program are proud sponsors of Sand Devil Sports.
In this game, the Sand Devils are up 10-0 with 6 minutes to go in the first quarter.
Yeah, you know, they've caused three turnovers at this, but I say four turnovers at this juncture. Emma Yazzie with a buck of three that caused a timeout, and so she's got 6 points. And so the Shamrocks at this point got to talk and say, hey, we got to settle down. You know, adrenaline, how it goes, it's really tough. And when you're playing on someone else's home court, you got to get by that burst. Ball kicked away and it's lost. Merchum loses the ball on the inbound pass. Nadia Begay going left side. Picks up her dribble out top to Torrance Begay. Emma Yazzie right side to Neveretter out top. Makeda Tolliman, an open three on the way. Nope, it's no good. Rebound fought for. Nadia Begay with it. Blocked by the younger Martinez Ryan. So a block shot. It'll still belong to the Sand Devils.
Yeah, nice play, but she pushed it out of bounds.
Inbounding Neveretter, Yazzie with it. Nadia Begay, top the key. Goes right side. Kind of a clog in the middle with Torrance Begay and Emma Yazzie. A steal on the run is Merchum. Back to Toak. No good. Offensive rebound and stick back. Ryan Martinez, a sophomore. Well done. So they get on the board at the 5:10 mark. And Torrance Begay has it, and a little fake pass up and in. That was beautiful. She looks like she's giving it up, and then she puts it down. A steal by the Sand Devils. Nev Redhair puts it up, and it should have been a foul, no call. Offensive rebound, Nadia Begay, and puts it in. The blitz is on. And defense, we're going to get a foul call, I believe, against Tolliman.
I think it's safe to say, Candyman, that they are not. The Shamrocks are not handling that full court press very well.
Well, it's tough. If you haven't faced a press like this, then you gotta do something. That's and the Sand Devils really, really doing a good job.
That's why it's 14-2.
A pass down court intercepted by Torrance Begay, and she goes between the defense. There will be a foul called. Nice take by Torrance Begay, and she'll get two. And that's going to be against Ryan Martinez. I believe that's going to be her second.
14-2, 4:43 to go. Sand Devils on top in the first quarter.
So the sophomore is going to come off the floor. Torrance Begay, 4 points. She misses her first. She's the best free throw shooter on the team. Well, Makeda is 75, but more takes for Torrance. She's a 70% shooter. So Torrance will get another shot. Coming into the ball game, Hannah Swathoff. And the next free throw, good by Torrance Begay. Swath out in for Martinez. Pass knocked away by Nev Redhair as Sellers just didn't know where to go with it.
Oh, she had a girl wide open, didn't see her.
Rory Martinez will inbound the ball. Again, this really tight Sand Devil defense. Rory Martinez has the ball blocked. Emma Yazzie, but she retrieves it. Emma does get the steal, and now she gets it in the corner, and Yazzie fakes the three, goes up, left hand, and it's no good, and we're going to get a foul called against Emma Yazzie, a player control foul. It'll be her first.
I don't agree. I'm sorry.
I believe Martinez was down under, had really good position. Inbound to Sellers. Back to Rory Martinez. Back to Sellers. Sellers across the timeline.
Haven't been down here in a while.
Nev Redhair on her. They're going to double up on her. Torrance Begay knocks it away with the ball. Merchum. She's going to go baseline, puts it up off the backboard, no good. Offensive rebound and by Torak, and here comes Nadia Begay, up and good.
Great pass by the quarterback, Begay.
Torrance Begay to Begay for the bucket. Pressure, and man, you can see the stress on the girls' faces.
Oh, my goodness.
And Martinez, that's Rory hits the deck, and Torrance Begay does not get the shot. Nadia Begay inside. Oh, and we're going to get a traveling call. Yeah. Sand Devils lose the basketball.
I thought she just moved her body, not her feet. Well, but I'm not going to knock the refs. They're great guys.
It's called the Sand Devil Shuffle. And, you know, you got to get paid a lot of money to earn that particular move. And now we're going to get a foul called against Emma Yazzie. That's going to be her second, and she'll come off the floor. 3:39 left in the first quarter. Page 17, the Shamrocks, 2. Inbounding will be Rory Martinez. Sandel, the defense, tenacious. Sellers with it. She's going to be surrounded. Bounce pass over to Murchum. She's going to come down court, take it herself. Stops, puts it off the glass. No good. And the rebound by Nev Redair. She flies in.
Pass
to Makeda Tolliman. Down court it comes. Nadia Begay skip over the defense to Nev Redair. Just outside the elbow. Redair from Nadia Begay. A basket.
19-2. Sand Devils on top.
Sand Devils want to take control of this game and not let go. With the ball, Merchant. Nev Redair taps away, but she's going to be called for the reach-in. So Nev with her first foul. Coming to the ball game will be the freshman, Jade Reed. And she'll come on for Emma Yazzie.
Saw about five members of Jade's family coming into the arena today.
Right.
I'm sure they're excited.
Yazzie sits down with 6 points and just phenomenal defense. Rory Martinez, that's Rory, double team, gets it in the hands of Sellers. Sellers, top of the key, splits the lane, loses the basketball. Down court it comes, Nadia to Nev. Nev, off the glass, good.
Oh, my. 2:43 to go in the first quarter.
McGalliard's going to call another timeout.
So let's take a timeout. 2:43 to go in the first quarter. And we are talking to the Sand Devils on top, 21-2 on the Powwow Trading Post scoreboard.
Go Sand Devils! H&R Block of Page has geared up for the 2020 tax season, and they're ready for your tax paperwork. Get your W-2s, unemployment, pensions, Social Security, interest income, and dividend paperwork all together, and their easy drop-off service can help everybody. They call you with questions and for your signature when completed. It keeps you safe and allows the staff to do their job to get the fastest, largest refund possible. H&R Block now open longer hours to help you with all your tax work. H&R Block of Page hopes for a Sand Devil win.
The Powwow Trading Post scoreboard, 21-2, the Sand Devils. And now we're going to get a push against the Sand Devils.
Diana Sakodian now.
That's going to be Nev. I think she's going to get her second, and she'll probably get a rest. But the Sand Devils just causing havoc for the Shamrocks. And we do get a buzzer. Nope, she's going to have to sit down. Didn't get to the scorer's table in time. Sellers out top, picked up by the freshman, Reed. Right side to Merchum. She's doubled up. Diane Sakodi in the lineup after that timeout. And pass to Torok. She is called for the travel, but, man, she had to work hard just to get the pass.
Oh,
eighth
my God.
Turnover for the Shamrocks as Chewy. That's Shamanique Nez. The junior will enter the lineup for the Page Sand Devils.
Yeah, Izzy Torok threw that ball like 40 yards.
Yep. Bad pass by the Sand Devils. Nadia Begay intercepted by Martinez. A three on the way. It's no good. And goes over the basket. That was from Sellers. So it'll be Sand Devil basketball. Inbounding will be Jade Reed.
And Jade knew not to go after that ball because no one was going
right.
to touch it.
Nadia Begay, again, an anticipation, very good by Merchum, but it just happens to be on the out-of-bounds line. But Merchum had that one clocked. Nadia Begay splits the defense. Down court, three on one break. Shamanique to Tolliman, who gets the take. That was a really good pass across the lane by Chewy.
And Tolliman got checked like a hockey player.
Hey, that's what you got to do. You got someone free to the lane. You ain't going to let them get the hockey puck up into the basket.
That was Rory Martinez with the foul, her first.
Tolliman on the line. Her first one, no good. Tolliman handles the ball so much, and it really surprised me. She's only been to the free throw line 8 times this season. shooting 75%. She'll get a second one after the miss. Next shot on the way, and that's good. Sand Devils stick with the pressure. Merchum with it, picked up by Tolleman. Merchum, left-hand dribble. She stops in the backcourt. She gets it to Torok. Back to Martinez. That's Rory. Go into the weave up top. Sand Devils defense, man-to-man, straight up. And the lob inside. Torok with it. Gets it into the corner. Shot by Merchum. No good. Rebound into the basket of Reed. Reed will get it out. And here come the Sand Devils. Nadia Begay will pull it back. Shamrock's back. Right side Chewy. She thinks three. Nope. She's going to pull it out. There's Tolleman, top of the key. Merchum on her. Gets it to Nadia Begay, left wing. 1 minute and 20 seconds left in this first quarter of action. 22-2 on the Powwow Trading Post scoreboard. Hey, give me a rainbow for three. That's Tolleman with a three. And I said it the other night, when you wear these green shoes, you better make a three. Merchum, ball tapped by Tolleman. Back to Merchum in the backcourt. And again, that's what pressure does to you. Hannah Swathout just, you know, she lost her place on the court. And that's going to be a turnover for the Shamrocks. Sand Devil basketball.
1:05 to go in the first quarter. Sand Devils on top 25-2.
Riedel inbound on her Swathout. Into the backcourt, Nadia Begay. Coming in on the attack, Chewy, right side, Tolleman. Diane Sakoti inside. Hey, get me that basketball. Nadia Begay has the ball taken away. Sellers on a breakaway, up, off the glass, good. Nice play by Reese Sellers for her first basket.
40 seconds to go, first quarter.
Tolleman with it down into the corner, Chewy. And there's Jade Reed out top. Tolleman, another three on the way, right side this time, off the rim, high. Martinez with a good rebound, that's Rory.
She's tall.
And down court, Reese Sellers, and she kicks off a nice pass to Merchum, a three on the way, misses the basket, no good. Reed with a rebound, and here come the Sand Devils down court. Nadia Begay to Chewy, left hand up and good. Dominique Nez. I would think they're clicking on all 12 cylinders. What do you think?
I think so.
Gads.
That's it.
And that's the end of the first quarter. The end of the first quarter at Sand Devil Gymnasium, 27-4, Sand Devils.
On the Powwow Training Post scoreboard.
Ardee's is proud to support the PHS Sand Devil basketball program and looks forward to seeing you at their drive-in restaurant soon. Ardee's keeps us all happy and feeling like things can get back to normal, since you can still get your favorite burger, burrito, or chicken sandwich with a quick and easy trip through Ardee's Drive-In. You can keep your family happier with a trip to Ardee's. Try bringing it home for dinner to make everybody happier in the house. Ardee's really is a Page tradition, just like Sand Devils basketball. Thanks, Ardee's, and go Sand Devils!
The road is calling you to get out of town safely. But how can you do it? Your vehicle isn't highway worthy, and getting stuck in winter could be dangerous. Think about Avis. They have all sizes of cars and vans to get you, your friends, and family out to see the beauty of the Grand Circle and beyond. Everybody's been wanting a getaway. You can do it safely and easily with the help of the friendly team at Avis. Just book it, and you can look forward to your getaway. Give Avis a call at 928-645-2024 or stop by the Page Airport location to book a car today. Go Sand Devils. We're behind you.
At the Sand Devils jungle. I mean, they are just so playing so well, defense and offense. And as we enter the second quarter, the Sand Devils lead 27-4. You might say the Shamrocks a little bit rattled in the
first
quarter.
Ran into a Sand Devil tsunami really quick and haven't been able to recover yet.
Jade Reed starts it off, pass over to Tolleman, almost goes out of bounds. She grabs it with her green shoes, and she's got it on the left wing, looking to get away, double team. Here's a shot by Diane Sakoti.
Beautiful pass from Torrance Begay, feeding the other big on the inside, and Sakoti finishes. Oh, my God.
We have a bucket here by Kylie Merchum. I forgot I was announcing. Kylie Merchum puts it in, and it's 29-6. Sand Devils on top, just underway in the second quarter.
That was a beautiful move that time by Merchum, snaking away through two Sand Devil defenders.
Tolleman Bounce pass is stolen. Stolen by Merchum. Merchum coming down, puts it up, and it goes in. That was a difficult layup. She was well defended.
Now that's their leading scorer, and she says, you know what, I've had about enough of this. We're going to have to do something.
That might be it.
A competitor.
Really.
She is a senior on the team.
Under 7 minutes in the first half. Torrance Begay with the ball. And Coach Whitehorse is going to call a timeout. We'll call a timeout too.
Well, and they were trying to say we got a zone. So
we have 30, we're going to take a break, a 30-second break. Sand Devils on top, 29-8.
Have you experienced the delicious chicken tacos from Paco's Tacos? From that first bite into the crispy, salty taco shell to the last taste of the seasoned chicken and green chili, you'll understand why Paco's Tacos is a favorite of the paid Sand Devils. After the game, hit the Paco's Tacos drive-thru and grab some of their tasty Mexican food for yourself. You'll definitely score extra points with your family. Paco's is open 7 days a week from 7 a.m. to 9 p.m. Paco's Tacos, hot, fresh, and fast.
Back into the second quarter of action. We've only been in the second quarter for a minute, but I think I see a little settling down of the Shamrocks.
Well, they've jumped into a zone now. See how the Sand Devils handle it. And a bad pass.
Evidently not well. Going down court, throwing up a crazy attempt on a layup, no good. Sand Devils recover. Talaman to Sakoti. To Torrance Begay. Torrance Begay puts it up, no good. Rebound by Rory Martinez, but a whistle.
Yeah, that was a nice defensive job by Martinez. And a foul on Torrance Begay, her first.
I think it was Talaman, her second.
Oh, you're right. I'm sorry. Yep, you bet.
That's the second time this year I've been right.
Ryan Martinez checking into the ballgame.
29 Sand Devils on the board, 8. For the visiting Shamrocks. Trying to get it out under this tough defense of the Sand Devils. Bringing it down court is Merchum. Merchum still has the ball, going around to the right side. She gets it over to Torek. Torek puts it up, no good. Rebound by the Shamrocks. That was Ryan Martinez, and she put it in for a bucket.
Great position by Martinez, and offensive rebound and stick back.
Sand Devils with the ball. Kira Jenkins in the game right now. Talaman over to the right. Three-point attempt by who's ever over there. And that looks like, that was Ariana. Ariana missed it, but the rebound for the Sand Devils. Over to the right-hand side. Talaman. Torrance thinking about a three from way over in the left. She fires over to the right. Talaman with the ball. Looking around, bounce pass to Ariana. Back to Talaman, who's going to shoot. No, she's not. She fooled me. Pass inside is stolen. Stolen by Ryan Martinez. Shamrocks with the ball. And an attempted layup was blocked. I think that was Talaman got her hand on the layup. No foul, but the ball went out of bounds off of the Sand Devils.
Indeed. Nadja Begay back in the ballgame. She'll enter in for one of the Jenkins girls, Kira.
5:21 to go here in the second quarter. Sand Devils with still a big lead. Something happened here. A little walking with the ball there by Kylie Merchum, and she had a clear shot for a layup.
They call that the Euro moonwalk. She gets called for the travel.
Sand Devil ball. No full court press right now by the Shamrocks. I mean, they're over there, but they're not really tight on the players. Ariana has the ball on the left wing. Fires it back to Talaman. Talaman to Nadia. Talaman corner.
Travel.
Ariana traveled. She faked a three and took off, but I think one foot started before the other one was supposed to.
Well, definitely what the Shamrocks have done is they've tried to take a little bit of juice out of the Sand Devils by sitting back in a zone, and the Sand Devils have not found their offensive rhythm yet.
In the second quarter.
No, Shamrocks 4 points in this quarter. Sand Devils have yet to get on the board.
Hannah Swartheit. In. Swarthen. Swarthen. I think I got it. She wears number 13 for the Shamrocks. Okay, Shamrocks ball, getting it in to Reese Sellers. Reese Sellers, the big scorer for the team, going down by herself on the right-hand side. Nadia was providing good defense. Sakoti knocks it out of bounds in an effort to get at the ball.
Nice reach by Sakoti. It went off of her, so it'll be Shamrock ball underneath their own basket.
Bringing it in will be Rory Martinez, looking for somebody to throw to. She finally finds Sellers. Now it's off into the corner in the person of the other Martinez. Shot up by Hannah Swarthout. No good, but I think she was hit.
Swarthout's shot drew the foul, and so she'll shoot two free throws.
Don't know who it's on yet. Oh, it's on Torrance. Torrance McGay, her first. 4:45 to go in the first half of the game. Hannah Swarthout, she's a sophomore, puts the first one in. Sand Devils on top, 29-11. They gave themselves a good cushion in the first. Swarthout dribbling, shooting, no good. Rebound, Ariana. Ariana then accidentally dribbles it out of bounds. We forgive her.
Well, yeah, like I said, the Shamrocks have done a good job of taking a little bit out of the air of the Sand Devil sails.
Mm-hmm. That's why it was good to have that cushion. I just saw who went in. Chewy's in. Chewy's in for the Sand Devils. Chewy Nez. Young lady with the ball couldn't figure out what to do with it, so they passed it outside. With the ball, Rory Martinez. Martinez over to Merchum. Merchum, and something goes on. Somebody's on one of the.
I think Torrance fell, and oh no, it's not going to be Torrance. It's against Diane Sokoti. That was away from the ball.
Oh, away from the ball, because, yeah, Torrance was at the ball. She was on the ground. So we're going to see Isabel, or they call her Izzy, Izzy Torek at the line, a senior, 5'11". Nice shot. Perfect. 29-12. A lot of high people on this team. They're tall.
Yes, they are.
All right, she's dribbling, puts it up. It's perfect. 29-13, the Sand Devils still on top, 4:27 to go in the first half. Tolleman being pressured, trying to bring it down court, and Torrance finally gets a nice pass from Nadia to clear things up, and now everything's back to normal. Nadia's got the ball, looking over the offense. Tolleman on the left. Tolleman over to back to Nadia. Thinking. Getting encouragement from Coach Whitehorse next to us. Nadia still back with the ball. She's looking to see. Nobody's really open. She's going to get back to Tolleman. Tolleman's going to get that ball and go toward the bucket. And then she's going to hand off to, I think, Nadia. And then Torrance put a shot up that did not go in. Rebound by the Shamrocks. Here comes Ryan Martinez. She puts it up, no good. Fight for the rebound. It's going to be Sand Devil ball.
Yeah, Nadia had the cake. Didn't get it, need it. Izzy knocked it away, and it'll belong to the Sand Devils.
Yes, indeed. 3:30 to go in the first half. Sand Devils up 29-13. With the ball, Chewy fires to Sakoti. She tried to put a shot up from the three-point line, but the free shot line, no good. And the ball bounces around, finally back in the hands of the Sand Devils. It traveled around team to team for a bit.
Yeah, Sand Devils definitely have been troubled by this zone defense. And what they're doing, they're really pushing the zone out.
Yeah.
Because they put a big down low and they have a big out top. And so that's a lot of cushion for them. And so they're making Sand Devils try to penetrate just like Makeda's doing.
Tolleman puts it up, no good. Rebound by Ryan Martinez with the ball. Sellers over to Merchum, but there's a fight for the ball. And who does it go to? It goes to the
Shamrocks.
We're going to have a full timeout. We'll take a 30-second timeout. 2:43 to go in the first half. Sand Devils on top, 29-13. We'll take a 30-second timeout.
Digging on your property line without knowing the location of underground utilities lines can result in damage to gas, electric, water, and sewer lines, which can lead to service disruptions, injuries, and costly repairs. Alliant Gas reminds you to call 811 first. It's the phone number to call before you start digging. It's free, and you should call 811 at least 3 days before you start any digging project, whether you're planning on doing it yourself or hiring a professional. Alliant Gas will mark the underground lines free. They deliver safety and service you can trust.
Free throw line.
I'm sure they're talking about that right now.
Are we back?
I think we are.
Are we?
Yeah, well, we are back.
Well, we're just chatting.
It gets really loud.
Yeah.
2:43. I got the score wrong when we went to break. 29-13 with 2:43 to go in the first half. Usually, we work with Al Nisi on these things. Usually, all season long, he's been next to us. Now
right.
He's behind us.
Right.
And it's like a full court press. I can't do it.
Well, you know, the Shamrocks have done a good job of slowing the Sand Devils down a bit and have gotten a little bit momentum shift. And in ball games, good teams will kind of try to set their own pace. And the Sand Devils definitely set the pace early, and the Shamrocks are trying to take that away from them.
I'm going to start out with Rory Martinez tossing out to a teammate. He's looking for Sellers, but Sellers is covered by Nadia. Instead, it goes to Ryan Martinez. Inside, she passes. And something happened there.
Izzy traveled.
Okay, that was Izzy Torek.
That's an Izzy travel. No passport to travel up here.
I had the official in front of me. I couldn't see a thing. All right, here we go. Torrance into Nadia. Nadia Begay is going to come in. Oh, she's quick with the basketball. Torrance is going to grab the ball. Back to Nadia. She's going to look things over and figure out what to do. I'm sure they're, whatever Coach Whitehorse said, they're going to try to do. So a bounce pass attempted by Nadia, kicked by one of the Shamrocks, Merchum. It went out of bounds. So it's still Sand Devil ball. 2:21 to go, first half. 29-13, Sand Devil girls on top. The undefeated girls. Torrance into Nadia, Begay to Begay. Nadia looking. Trying to find a crease, a place to go in. Almost a three-point attempt there by Jade Reed. The ball is loose down there, but it does belong to the Shamrocks who are coming down court.
Ryan Martinez stepped in the pass lane, just took that ball away, and Shamrocks with it.
Reese Sellers, covered by Tolliman. She's blocked out, and pass attempt is sloppy, but it gets there. Sellers tries a three, in and out, rebound by Torrance. Torrance McGay with the rebound. Toss it down to Nadia. Nadia kind of like the captain right now. Three-point attempt by Tolliman, no good. Doesn't hit the basket. Ooh. Sellers gets the rebound.
Torrance McGay fortunate enough to pick up a foul.
Sellers to the left, trying to get it over to Martinez. That would be Rory Martinez. She passes inside to Torek. Torek, bounce pass right to Tolliman. Sand up a ball, 1:15 to go. Way down there, Torrance gets it, layup on the left-hand side, perfect, on the run.
That was a dime by Makeda Tolliman. What a great assist and a great finish by Torrance Begay from the left side.
1 minute to go in the first half, Sand Devils 31-13. The Shamrocks of Yuma Catholic with the ball. Here comes Reese Sellers all by herself, puts it up from about 5 feet away, no good. Tolliman gets the rebound. She passes ahead long to Jade Reed. Jade Reed over to Nadia Begay, a little too long. They have time, 40 seconds.
She put that up with the alley-oop. Nadia Begay should have gone up and dunked it.
Makeda Tolliman with the ball back to Nadia. It's been it's all been Nadia Begay and Tolliman when they're on offense. She tries to pass. It's batted away by one of the Shamrocks who's going down court, and that was Kylie Merchum. All the way down, puts it in.
Great defensive play by Merchum to tap it away and then come down court to get the basket.
Jade Reed, almost a three attempt. Now she's blocked. She has to get rid of the ball, but she can't. They end up with the ball, and it's Merchum with the ball by herself. Nobody else near her, and she scores two, and that's the end of the first half of action. So we've come to the half. The Sand Devils are on top. 31-17, and so we're going to take a break, and why not? We'll take a two. We're going to take a two and a half minute break right now on the Powwow Trading Post scoreboard. Well, that's what we're going to talk, aren't we?
Please welcome to the court for a halftime performance, your Sand Devils cheer team!
In the heart of Page, on the corner of the Boulevard and Elm Street, there's a new pizza place, Little Caesars.
Pizza, pizza.
Okay, you got us. But new ownership and a pizza mobile are worth talking about. We're not Big Pizza. We're Little Caesars. Page America is crazy about Little Caesars Pizza. Order online, then skip the register with Little Caesars Pizza Portal Pickup. Little Caesars is the world's easiest way to pizza.
The Boilermakers Western States Apprenticeship Program is for you. A great career established to promote efficient and high-quality field construction by skilled craftsmen and craftswomen in the Boilermaker welding trade. You could participate in self-studies, paid on-the-job training, and in-classroom instruction. It's an earn-as-you-learn apprentice program. Request your application for apprenticeship at www.westernstatesjac.org. The Boilermakers Western States Apprentice Program are proud sponsors of Sand Devil Sports.
And twice, I called it Page, Florida.
Well, sure. Hey, well, you know, you're a man of the world, and it's kind of tough to even know where you're at any time of the day.
I don't know where I am now.
I don't either. Hey, the Shamrocks, man, you got to give it to them. They turned around that second quarter because, man, they were under the barrage. They were under the tsunami, a 27-4 first quarter for the Sand Devils, and the Shamrocks go into a zone. They changed the momentum. They stopped the Sand Devil offense. And the Sand Devils only got two buckets in that quarter. And the Shamrocks behind Kylie Merchum, they picked up 13 in that quarter. Again, holding the Sand Devils to just four. So, hey, they came up here to play. And you cannot rest.
No, and I think Coach McGalliard is right now in the locker room telling them what a great job they did.
Right.
We're in the ball game,
hey,
girls.
Let's do it. Stay aggressive. Let's go through the stats for the first half. 13 turnovers for the Shamrocks, 6 rebounds, 2-for-4 from the free throw line. And the scoring, 10 points for their leading scorer, Merchum. Then 4 points for Ryan Martinez, 2 points for Reese Sellers, and 2 points for Izzy Torok. And then 1 point for Hannah Swathout. For the Page Sand Devils, 8 turnovers. They had 5 in that second quarter. That's where the Sand Devils were really not taking care of the ball on their pass to the wings. And so the Shamrocks doing a good job there. 13 rebounds for the Sand Devils. 3 for 5 from the foul line, scoring for the Sand Devils, 7 for Torrance Begay, 6 for both Nevret Hare and Emma Yazzi, 4 points each for Nadia Begay, Makeda Talaman, 2 points for Shamanique Nez, and then also Diane Sakoti with 2 points. And the Sand Devils got to get back to what got them there. They've got to keep that pressure defense on them. But like I said, I'm thinking Meacham just came out in that second quarter and said, hey, let's go. That's what senior leadership is all about.
Mm-hmm.
And so they're doing well. And then that zone defense, they went out top with the big. It was Ryan at the top of the zone defense.
Right.
And you had Rory in the back. And both those kids go right around 6'1", 6'2". And so they've done a really good job to get themselves literally, I mean, 14 points is really nothing with a three-point line out here.
Absolutely not, so, especially looking at that second quarter.
Yeah, great job by the Shamrocks. But the Sand Devils, like I said, they're going to hear it from Ryan Whitehorse in terms of, listen, you got to be able to work that defense. You got to be able to split the seams. You can't just send it there and just lazily pass around the ball around the perimeter. You got to attack it, cause the defense to come in, hit the baselines, get it to Torrance at the high post, look down low. But again, you try to go down low, and there Rory is there to meet you with her 6'2
height.
Yeah,
that's true. And yeah, so, Torrance hasn't been getting open under the bucket like she always does.
Right. Well, like I said, it's all credit to the Shamrocks right now. But I will tell you, the Sandals are going to come out and find a way. They got to put that pressure back on and kind of ride the horse that got them here at this point. It's got to be that defense that really cracks it for them. And so, yeah, we got a good ball game here. And, again, 7-hour bus ride probably for these kids. That takes a lot out of you. We know what it is to travel. And Yuma probably the same way because they're not close to too many. They got, of course, within the Tucson area and those kind of things. But our shortest trip up here is 2.5 hours.
I know.
And we love it when teams have to travel all the way up to Page. It's the most beautiful place in the world. But if you got to get off a bus and then get your legs, it's a tough place.
I don't think they're here to sightsee either.
No, they aren't.
Just a thought.
Yeah. Well, I hope they are because when they first come in, we welcome them and say, hey, look at our south wall. And you know what's up there?
Yeah.
Nothing but championship things and this, that, and the other. But like I said, the Sand Devils are going to have to actually regroup a little bit. And any win in this tournament is a good win. And so that's what the Sand Devils are looking for. One and done in this tournament. And so the Shamrocks certainly aren't out of this.
So let's take a one-minute break right now. We're not too far from the second half. And again, the halftime score, Sand Devils 31 and the Shamrocks 17 on the Powwow Trading Post scoreboard.
Go Sand Devils! H&R Block of Page has geared up for the 2020 tax season, and they're ready for your tax paperwork. Get your W-2s, unemployment, pensions, Social Security, interest income, and dividend paperwork all together, and their easy drop-off service can help everybody. They call you with questions and for your signature when completed. It keeps you safe and allows the staff to do their job to get the fastest, largest refund possible. H&R Block now open longer hours to help you with all your tax work. H&R Block of Page hopes for a Sand Devil win.
RD's is proud to support the PHS Sand Devil basketball program and looks forward to seeing you at their drive-in restaurant soon. RD's keeps us all happy and feeling like things can get back to normal since you can still get your favorite burger, burrito, or chicken sandwich with a quick and easy trip through RD's drive-in. You can keep your family happier with a trip to RD's. Try bringing it home for dinner to make everybody happier in the house. RD's really is a Page tradition, just like Sand Devils basketball. Thanks, RD's, and go Sand Devils!
I like to look up some of the stuff, historic stuff, from the teams we play, the cities we play, from Yuma. A lot of famous people, Cesar Chavez, the labor leader, was there.
The lettuce guy.
Curly Culp, the Hall of Famer for the Chiefs.
Oh, the wrestler.
No, Curly Culp, the lineman for the Chiefs,
but he
Super
was a,
Bowl III.
He was a championship wrestler at ASU.
Oh,
yes,
thank
sir.
You very
yeah,
much.
Yeah.
That's great.
Yeah.
And also Curtis Lee, who gave us the song Pretty Little Angel Eyes.
Well, here we go. Third quarter action about to begin here. And the Sand Devils have their starting lineup on the floor. There were two ladies out of it because of two fouls, Emma Yazzi and Neb Redhair. So they're on the floor with two fouls. No one else was real any kind of foul trouble. Makeda Talaman, I think, too. Coleman, baseline, kicks it over to Nev Redhair, and she's going to be fouled and shoot two. That's nice great. Look by Toleman across the lane.
And speaking of look, that was a nice look on offense.
Yeah, it was. That's a good set to come out with, and a beautiful pass across the lane to Nev as she broke in. She'll get two shots. Nev Redhair, man, I'll tell you what, she is a – I had a chance to interview her as she's going to Stanford University.
She's going to be a doctor.
Yeah, 63% shooter from the foul line, and more importantly, she's one of the 4.3% of the students that applied to Stanford that got in. Isn't that 4.3%? Hardest university in the United States to get in, and she got in. Next shot on the way, good. Full court pressure by the Sand Devils, and immediately they get the turnover. Nev Redhair there goes, and she is fouled hard. And again, if you're going to foul someone, make sure they don't make the shot, and that was a sure foul. And that was by, we'll see who it was. So the second really quickly on Merchum. So she comes out within the first 30 seconds and picks up two fouls. Shot by Redhair, up and good.
I feel like deja vu. She was just here half a minute ago.
Yeah, there you go. Hey, put me back there. Country road. Next shot up, high arcing shot, good. Inbounding Rory Martinez. Sand Devils on the defense. Down court it goes. Interception, Nev Redhair. Sand Devils two, turnovers right away. Sand Devils go to work. Nadia Begay. And again, that zone defense, let's see how they attack it. Down in the corner, inside to Torrance Begay, back out to Makeda Tolman, Yamayazi, and that's how you beat a defense. You got to move that ball quickly. Don't hold it too long. You got to get that defense out of position. Beautiful pass. Nev Redhair with the dish, and Torrance Begay with the finish. Nice.
Well, this looks like the first quarter again.
Well, not yet. Nice break there. Here comes Izzy. Izzy goes up, and she's going to be called for the charge. Nice job by Torrance Begay to pick up that foul. Player control. Sand Devil basketball. So another turnover for the Shamrocks. They're going to go into their full court pressure. Nev Redhair in the backcourt. Gets it to Toleman. Toleman down court to Nadia Begay. Pulls up inside to Torrance. One big step and in. Beautiful pass, Begay. Great finish. Begay to Begay. Torrance with the finish. Ball, Rory Martinez to Merchum. Merchum in the backcourt. She's just wanted to get out of that double team. She goes into the lane, still with the ball, knocked away by Torrance Begay. Wow, she was going, that looked like she was going in between the sticks.
I think there was a foul on someone there, right?
No, it was just knocked out by Torrance.
Got it.
38-17, 6:26 left in this third. Sand Devils up. And up with the shot is Merchum drawing the foul. And I believe that's going to be on Emma Yazzie. It's going to be her third. Merchum.
6:24 to go in the third quarter here. Sand Devils on top, 38-17.
Yeah, Merchum with a couple free throws. Shot up, and it's no good. Merchum, a good-looking ball player. And like I said, they recovered pretty good from that blitzkrieg, that tsunami in the first quarter, and have come out, and the Sand Devils are backing at it. And Ariana Jenkins will replace Emma Yazzie, who has three fouls. So She'll probably be off the bench fairly quickly to see how this game flows. Next shot by Merchant. Good. She's got 11 points. And ball off the legs of Sellers from Ariana Jenkins. And Nev Redhair will take it in now.
Yeah, when Emma came off the court, the coach said to her, get ready to go in. Get ready to go in.
Yeah, be ready. Nev to Makeda Toleman. In the backcourt it goes to Nadia Begay. She's going to go on the attack. She pulls it up wisely, because she had Rory Martinez in front of her and a couple of others of the Shamrocks. Bounce pass intercepted by Ryan. Now a pass intercepted by Toleman. She goes up a floater in the lane. No good. Rebound Ryan Martinez. And a foul will be called on,
I think, on Nev Redhair.
It's going to be on Nev Redhair. That'll be her third.
That's expensive.
Yep. 38-18, 20-point lead for the Sand Devils. 2 minutes gone in this third quarter. Ryan Martinez with it, gets back to Merchum. Merchant picks up the dribble. Back to Martinez. Martinez is going to get doubled up. Picks the dribble up and never had her on a cross the backcourt to Merchum with Nadia Begay on her. Nice screen out top. Ball sent back to Ryan. Martinez down court. Makeda Tolliman to Torres.
Oh, yeah.
With the finish on that turnover. A beautiful feed by Tolliman. Here comes Merchum. She's going to get up ahead of steam, and she finds a wide open Rory Martinez, and I think the officials missed that one. Torrance Begay, a hack at it, but it'll be called a block, and it'll belong to the Sand Devils. Sand Devil basketball. Nadia Begay picks it up to Nevret here in the corner, down low to Torrance Begay, and she's in between a Shamrock sandwich.
That was a sandwich. Yes,
yeah,
it
that was.
Was
a Shamrock sandwich. And there's going to be a foul called on that. It could be against Ryan Martinez. Yeah, that's going to be her third, I believe.
It is.
So her third, team fourth. Ariana Jenkins will float it up to nobody, but nobody is Nevret here. And the ball is going to be tapped out of bounds. It'll belong to the Sand Devils. Said it went off of Nev's leg. Eight to one run here at Sand Devils in this third quarter. Rory Martinez out front. And Torrance Begay on her. Nice job by Torrance to cut her off. Now switched Makeda Tolliman and the ball thrown away. Nev Redhair with it. She comes up court. And Ryan Martinez with it. Blocks it, but will be called for the foul. Ryan Martinez, I believe, with her, maybe her fourth.
That would be amazing.
Yeah.
She's not happy about it.
She said
words for her coach.
She said, well, say, coach, I did it just like you taught me. I had my hand straight up.
Did you see her?
When bodies are moving, though, it's kind of hard to stay straight up. Nev Redhair, two shots up.
And you were right. That's her fourth one.
First one
and
in.
She's key.
Yeah, indeed. So the Sand Devils come out and control the third quarter at this point. Next shot, Redhair, no good off the rim. And ball going to go off of Ariana Jenkins. Nope, it's going to go, let's see what they call. I better wait for the officials. And it'll go to the Sand Devils.
Yeah, it must have been obvious because nobody was wondering except you.
12-footer on the way. Nev Redhair, no good. Into the hands of Ryan Martinez. I make that Rory Martinez. And Shamrocks will go to work. Sellers, nice move. Go around Ariana Jenkins, and she'll be fouled. And she'll go to line shooting two. Ariana Jenkins. Boy, she got around Ariana Jenkins in a hurry, and Jenkins was in the chase mode. Fouled her on the way up. And she'll go to the line shooting two.
Yeah, Reese Sellers is probably the shortest one on the team, but she's a hustler.
Yeah, well, hey, you don't get to this part of the tournament without having some players, and Yuma does. First shot up by Sellers is good. Next shot on the way, and that is off the rim. It's no good. Torrance Begay with a rebound. And here come the Sand Devils. Makeda Tolliman down to Jenkins, back to Tolliman. Tolliman to Begay. And you'll watch Jenkins run the baseline as well as Nev and either Torrance. Or Jenkins will hit the free throw line. Nadia Begay stumbles, gets her balance, and comes back out top, reset the offense. Still facing that zone defense. The only difference here, they're not pushing the Sand Devils out that much. Three-pointer, Nev Redhair. Nev Redhair. 12 points for Redhair. Sand Devils now extend their lead, and we're going to get a foul against Makeda Tolliman as Merchant hits the deck.
That was inadvertent, though. She didn't mean it.
That's right. So 25-point lead for the Sand Devils. 3:40 left here on the Powwow Trading Post scoreboard. Rory Martinez picks it up. Turnaround. Jump shot from 12 right baseline, and it's nothing but net. Beautiful shot.
Sweet shot.
By Martinez. That's her first bucket. Sand Devils holding on, three on the way. Makeda Tolliman, bang, 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 bring the rain. Another three, Tolleman, and that gets a timeout from the Shamrocks.
3:16 to go in the third period. Sand Devils on top, 47-21 on the Powwow Trading Post scoreboard.
The road is calling you to get out of town safely. But how can you do it? Your vehicle isn't highway worthy, and getting stuck in winter could be dangerous. Think about Avis. They have all sizes of cars and vans to get you, your friends, and family out to see the beauty of the Grand Circle and beyond. Everybody's been wanting a getaway. You can do it safely and easily with the help of the friendly team at Avis. Just book it, and you can look forward to your getaway. Give Avis a call at 928-645-2024 or stop by the Page Airport location to book a car today. Go Sand Devils, we're behind you.
Sand Devils up 47-21 on the Powwow Trading Post scoreboard, and the Shamrocks will have the ball out. They thought they were underneath their own basket, and they had to readjust. And Rory says, what are you guys doing? Let's go. We got to go up the other side to score. Rory Martinez, really a good ball handler out top. And we're going to get a foul called, and that's going to be a player control against the Shamrocks. That's going to be against Izzy.
That was away from the ball. Yeah. Nadia ended up on the floor.
Yeah, she took a shot. But, I mean, bodies were moving really quickly in the lane. And so Izzy picks up her second, I believe. It says number one up there, but we'll see what happens. Jenkins with it down in the corner. Nev, a three on the way. It's no good off the back of the rim. Rebound being fought for. Torrance Begay, and Izzy comes down with it. So nice hustle by Torok. Rory Martinez to Sellers. Sellers goes around Makeda. Tolleman splits the defense, goes up, no good. Tolleman with a rebound, and here come the Sand Devils. Tolleman scanning the court. She finds Nadia Begay all alone, and Nadia cannot finish. Rebound by Sellers, and the Sand Devils trying to surround the Shamrocks. Jenkins chasing Martinez. Ball slowed down. Sand Devils stick with their man. Martinez in trouble. Jenkins there, but Nadia Begay chasing Sellers. Sellers, penetration, gets it to Merchum from the right side. It's no good. Torrance Begay down court to Ariana Jenkins, and Jenkins chases it down and does the smart thing. She's going to bring it out. Nice job by Torrance Begay, but really great job by Jenkins. Didn't force the play.
Ariana.
Let it come to her. So the Sand Devils will go to work on the offense. Out top, Nev Redhair. And a three-pointer on the way. Jenkins off the backboard. No good. Offensive rebound. Nadia Begay. Sand Devils reset. Back to Jenkins. Right side to Nev Redhair. Out top to Tolleman as she pops out. Nadia Begay, left side, looking for Torrance, not going to get it there. Jenkins all alone, top of the key, three, no good, off the rim. And the fight for the rebound, offensive rebound, Torrance Begay, no good. Nev Redhair with the offensive tap, and that's good. Two offensive boards and a basket.
1 minute to go, third period. Sand Devils now have a lead of 49-21.
So Reese has her pass intercepted. And that's Makeda Tolleman coming down court. She loses control a bit, tries to go back in, and gets it into Torrance. Torrance going to split, get it to Nadia from the right side. Good. A great pass that time by Torrance Begay.
Sanchez are passing so well.
To Nadia. And Ariana Jenkins takes it away from Rory Martinez. Left hand by Nev Redhair. No good. It'll belong to the Sand Devils.
Ariana. Yeah, Ariana.
That'll be, I think, her second.
She didn't mean it.
30-point lead now for the Sand Devils at the 32-second mark as the Sand Devils bring the freshman Jade Reed in and Diane Sakoti. Redhair leaves with 12 points. And Diane Sakoti checks in. Torrance Begay will sit. And Torrance with 15 points on the evening. Sellers with it. Makeda Tolleman on her. Gets a screen from Izzy. And Makeda Tolleman with a steal. Up she goes, and it's no good. The follow by Torok. And here come the Shamrocks. A long distance pass. Nobody home.
You know, I didn't notice until about 3 minutes ago. The Sand Devils are wearing masks, and the Shamrocks are not.
Yeah, they have a choice.
Yeah,
the AIA said they don't have to. And No, we were talking about that game last time. I didn't bring it up because they were wearing masks, and but yeah, they've got used to it.
And evidently,
there's a sensitivity on the reservation that a lot of other communities don't have when it comes to this COVID situation.
That's a great point. Thank you.
6 seconds on the clock here in the third. Makeda Tolliman in the lane, step back, three on the way, no good. At the end of the third quarter, the Powwow Trading Post scoreboard says 51-21.
On the Powwow Trading Post scoreboard.
Have you experienced the delicious chicken tacos from Paco's Tacos? From that first bite into the crispy, salty taco shell to the last taste of the seasoned chicken and green chili, you'll understand why Paco's Tacos is a favorite of the paid Sand Devils. After the game, hit the Paco's Tacos drive-thru and grab some of their tasty Mexican food for yourself. You'll definitely score extra points with your family. Paco's is open 7 days a week from 7 a.m. to 9 p.m. Paco's Tacos, hot, fresh, and fast.
Digging on your property line without knowing the location of underground utilities lines can result in damage to gas, electric, water, and sewer lines, which can lead to service disruptions, injuries, and costly repairs. Alliant Gas reminds you to call 811 first. It's the phone number to call before you start digging. It's free, and you should call 811 at least 3 days before you start any digging project, whether you're planning on doing it yourself or hiring a professional. Alliant Gas will mark the underground lines free. They deliver safety and service you can trust.
We are back at Page High School in Page, Arizona, and we're watching the Sand Devils in their second postseason game. And right now, as we enter the fourth quarter, they're up. They are up 51-21.
And a great third quarter again, 20 points to 4 in this quarter. Again, defense triggers Sand Devils offense. Great job. In that quarter, 8 points for Torrance Begay, and 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 points for Nev Redhair. Shot put up, no good. Jade Reed, the freshman, with the rebound. And here come the Sand Devils. Nev Redhair with it. Out top, Yazzie has come back into the ball game. She's got 3 fouls on it. Torrance Begay, left wing. Nev Redhair, top of the key. Right side to Emma Yazzie. Yazzie gets by Sellers, and actually Sellers overplays the pass. Mm-hmm. And Torrance Begay drives on Izzy, goes in, finds Martinez, but puts it up from the left side with the right hand. And Torrance Begay with 17 points now. It's really awesome to see bigger girls that can move well and handle the ball well. And we've got plenty of them on the floor.
Whoa!
Merchum with the basket. It will be waved off. Merchum says, oh, no way. Torrance Begay had the position. Foul on Merchum. Player control foul. Turnover, Sand Devils basketball. Just underway here in the fourth, and the Sand Devils will be looking to move on. And that game will be, as I understand, next Wednesday. Is that correct? I think that's what's happening. And we'll take a look at that after
St.
the ball
Patrick's
game.
Day.
Nev Redhair, turnaround, blocked by Ryan Martinez as she's back in. She's got 4 fouls. And it'll belong to the Sand Devils underneath their own basket. Redhair will inbound. Looking inside. Pops out to Jade Reed. Torrance Begay with the ball top of the key. Reed. Bring it out top. Nev Redhair looking to the baseline. Not going to go there as Jade Reed comes along, has to retrieve the basketball as Merchum got her hands on it. But Sand Devils retain possession. Torrance Begay being working on Torok. Right side, Jade Reed into Nev Redhair baseline. And there's Diane Sakoti just inside the three-point arc, and it's blocked by Ryan Martinez, and it'll be a held ball, possession arrow, Sand Devils. Nice block by Ryan Martinez. She's just a sophomore. She's got a good career in front of her.
No.
Nev Redhair, bounce pass to Reed. Out top it goes to Emma Yazzie. Nev Redhair gets the benefit of a screen on the inside, but she can't take advantage of it as the other Martinez is there. And so Sand Devils will back it out. Torrance Begay to Emma Yazzie. Emma Yazzie finds a little seam, puts it up on the left side, and she's going to get called for the player control foul. It'll go the other way. Turnover Sand Devils. Nice position. And I didn't get the number.
That's her fourth.
I think that may have been Merchum. I'm not sure. Sellers back to Martinez. That's Rory. Across the timeline she comes. Down court it goes to Merchum. Merchum on the inside puts a shot up. It's no good. Nev Redhair comes down with it. She's looking up court. She's going to hold on to it. Sandals are set. Jade Reed to Emma Yazzie. She has a wide open three. Puts it up. It's no good. Rebound inside. It goes to Nev Redhair. Comes around Ryan Martinez and puts it up on the backside of the basket. Nev Redhair now with 15 points.
It's amazing somebody got that ball on the Sand Devils because there were 3 6-footers all around.
Yep. Rory Martinez into the hands of Merchum. The freshman picking up Merchum. Nice little reverse by Sellers. No good. Redhair Yazzie with the rebound. And she'll hold it up here. Halfway done with this fourth quarter. Drive by Nev Redhair. She stops, puts it up over the outstretched arms of Martinez. That's Ryan Martinez, who has 4 fouls. So
that was
nice job that time by Redhair.
That was in a crowd.
17 for Redhair. Sellers gets a screen out top, and she drives, and we're going to get a blocking foul called on Redhair, I believe. That may be her fourth. Let's see what it is.
Yeah, Reese Sellers ended up on the floor. She's fine.
And so that's going to be a foul on Nev Redhair, her fourth. And it'll be Sellers on the free throw line shooting 2 shots.
I think that the coach of the Shamrocks is going to get some of the other girls in because it's going to be their last game of the year.
Shot by Sellers up and good. And as you say, it's going to be number 13 in Hannah Swathout. Number 23, Frankie Sandoval, a freshman. And there's one other one there, number 22, Eva Garcia, a freshman.
And the starters who came off looked really, really sad.
Next shot up is good by Sellers. So Sandoval's Reed will bring it across the timeline. And we get a timeout called by Coach Ryan Whitehorse, 57-23.
With 2:40 left in the game on the Powwow Trading Post scoreboard.
In the heart of Page, on the corner of the Boulevard and Elm Street, there's a new pizza place, Little Caesars.
Pizza, pizza.
Okay, you got us. But new ownership and a pizza mobile are worth talking about. We're not Big Pizza. We're Little Caesars. Page America is crazy about Little Caesars Pizza. Order online, then skip the register with Little Caesars Pizza Portal Pickup. Little Caesars is the world's easiest way to pizza.
Yeah, we are back. And the only score we have right now is Snowflake beating Sholo. The only one that we have right now. What we're most interested in is
What was the score in that ball game? Do you have it?
It just says that that Snowflake has a 3-point lead.
Oh, okay.
But I'm interested in Valley Christian and Thatcher.
Okay. Here come the Sand Devils. They've got Lindsay Tree is in here. Jade Reed, the freshman, gets the ball. Out top, Kara Jenkins, Chewy in the ball game, and Calla Smith for the first time. Tree with it, bounce into Chewy. Chewy out top to Reed. Inside to Calla Smith, she puts it on the floor and she tries to go over Ryan Martinez. It's blocked, picked up by Chewy, and the ball being tapped away on the inside by the Shamrocks. Turnover, Sand Devils. And here comes Sellers. Little Euro up and in with the left hand. Nice job by Sellers.
Oh, we have that turning clock, don't we? We can keep it right here. This is a timeout. We'll keep it right here.
Oh, it's a timeout. There you go.
1:59 to go in the ball game, and the Sand Devil girls have this game in hand. They're leading 57-25, and we're going to see Summer Begay come in.
We got her name here. I apologize beginning of the game because she came in the ball game last game, the first round game, and didn't have her on the roster, wearing number 42. I think she's a sophomore or a freshman. I don't know. Summer Begay. And the other one we mentioned that we may be seeing is Trinity Curley, a sophomore, number 52. But Sand Devils, a good effort here. They weathered a second quarter where they only scored 4 points and then came out and reestablished themselves on the offense, but triggered by the defense.
That was an amazing second quarter the Shamrocks.
It was.
Played really well.
Well, they switched things up, and it took Sand Devils a quarter to regroup. And the Sand Devils will have the ball with 1 minute and 59 left here in this ball game. Up 57-25 on the Powwow Trading Post scoreboard.
Summer Begay out there.
Kara Jenkins with the ball. Summer Begay, right side, out back out to Jenkins, to Chewy, left wing. Baseline, Tree will be running the baseline. Kala inside, facing the big Shamrocks. A turnaround shot, Kala Smith off the backboard, no good. Rebound. And that's Garcia with it, Eva Garcia, freshman.
Chewy wanted that ball.
Yes, she did.
All right, here comes Trinity Curley.
Number 52 in the ball game, Trinity Curley. She's a good-looking sophomore. And again, the Sand Devils, as Arizona Republic says, man, been dominating 3A for 10 years. And what they want to do this year is get back to the finals for the fifth straight year. Sand Devils double up in the wing. Shamrocks get it into the corner. And that's number 11, Armina Piedra.
Under a minute to go.
Garcia with it, kicks it out top to.
Oh.
That was a shot by Frankie Sandoval. Rebound goes to Garcia. Out top it goes to Sandoval again. Frankie kicks it off to Brianna Paisano, and she just hands it off to Frankie Sandoval. Shot up, no good.
Rebound.
Kala Smith, and here come the Sand Devils. Kara Jenkins with it, and oh, I tell you, Summer is really shy, and the coach is back here saying shoot it, and that's a shot by Curley. It's no good. A three-pointer. Went off the back of the rim, and the rebound to Hannah Swathout. Whether it is Frankie Sandoval,
I take
that back. That's Brianna Paisana, and she gets it across the timeline. Frankie Sandoval gets it across the timeline, and that's the end of the ball game from Sand Devil Gymnasium, round two, quarterfinals, and the Sand Devils will advance to the semifinals. That'll be right here next Wednesday, but the score, 57-25.
Let's take a 2.5 minute break right now on the Powwow Trading Post scoreboard. That'd be a last break.